Now is the time to lift our nation from the quicksands of racial injustice to the solid rock of brotherhood. Now is the time.
During the 1950s, many courageous leaders rose to prominence on the front lines of social justice. Although it's important to recognize these key figures and their impact on the civil rights movement, it was mostly ordinary people who played a part helping to unite a divided nation. And once again, many of them were children. Young people made the deliberate moral choice to come face to face with injustice in many of the fiercest battles for racial equality. Some of these were fought within the walls of public schools. Through a landmark case known as Brown versus the Board of Education, the lawyers for the NAACP, the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People, argued and won a Supreme Court decision stated that segregation in public schools was in fact illegal. It was a 7-year-old girl from Topeka, Kansas, who helped overturn the decision that kept black and white children from attending the same schools. Because Linda Brown was black, she was forced to go to an all-black elementary school. Since the school was far from home, she needed to take the bus to get there. The only way to catch the bus was to walk through a train switching yard. Her father didn't understand why being black meant his daughter had to struggle to get to school every morning, while an all-white school was just a few blocks from her home. On May 17, 1954, with the help of her father and attorneys from the NAACP, including Thurgood Marshall, Linda's long walk came to an end. A unanimous Supreme Court decision declared that school segregation based on race was illegal. It impacted students in 17 states that had legally segregated schools and ultimately influenced almost every school in the U.S. Although part of the nation complied with the decision and began to integrate their schools, many were not willing to let go of their old prejudices and practices.
This nation was founded by men of many nations and backgrounds. It was founded on the principle that all men are created equal, and that the rights of every man are diminished when the rights of one man are threatened. It ought to be possible, therefore, for American students of any color to attend any public institution they select without having to be backed up by troops.
Chaos and angry faces outside of Little Rock High School on September 4th, 1957 were evidence that the struggle for racial equality was far from over. The mob was against the court-ordered desegregation of their school. Nine black teenagers who became known as the Little Rock Nine were scheduled to attend classes alongside 2,000 white students.
We began moving forward. The eerie silence of that moment would forever be etched in my memory. All I could hear was my own heartbeat and the sounds of boots clicking on the stone. Step by step, we climbed upward, where none of my people had ever before walked as a student.
Amid the threats, spit, and fury of a raging mob, the children walked forward. It was children who had to return each morning to face the persistent voice of segregation and hatred. They did it so they and eventually their children might someday be treated as equals. Weeks after school started, it still wasn't safe for the children to enter the building. It took the brave efforts of a few teachers, parents, students, and finally, intervention from the president to control the angry resistance. Eisenhower sent 1,000 paratroopers to join 10,000 members of the Arkansas National Guard who were required to provide protection. As the rest of the nation watched television reports from the security of their living rooms, 9 courageous young people confronted generations of resistance to change.
If resistance to the federal court order ceases at once, the further presence of federal troops will be unnecessary. The city of Little Rock will return to its normal habits of peace and order, and a blot upon the fair name and high honor of our nation in the world will be removed. Thus will be restored the image of America and of all its parts as one nation, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.